Keith Poynton from Sandbach in Cheshire. Lee Smith from Thetford in Norfolk. John Carpenter from Porchester in Hampshire. Judith Landry from Deal in Kent. Jennifer Cox from Birmingham. Deborah Ashmore from Leyland in Lancashire. John Barter from Blackpool. Jan Edwards from Birmingham. Jan Pedersen from Pevensey Bay in East Sussex. Kevin Hearn from Forest Hill in London. Mari Metcalf from Benderloch in Argyll. Norman Silver from Brandon in Suffolk. George Pulley from Southmore in Oxfordshire. Michael Walker from Bolton and Jenny Veer from North Curry in Somerset are all here to play 15 to 1, presented by William G. Stewart.
Thank you. Hello. Our previous winner today is Jenny Veer from North Curry in Somerset. A warm welcome back, Jenny. Yesterday's winner, Dan Field, is today's target on the finals board. There it is, and a winning score above 142 would remove his name. Kevin at number 10 is blind, so if he gets into the second round, Janet will nominate for him. That's all you need before we start, so off we go. And we begin with Keith Poynton from Sandbach in Cheshire. Books and scientists, Keith. Which British cosmologist, author of many best-selling science books, including A Brief History of Time, celebrated his 60th birthday this year?
Stephen Hawking.
And Lee, please. Which mobile phone company sponsored the Oaks and the Derby at Epsom this year?
Vodafone.
John, please. In July, the people of which North African country celebrated the marriage of their king, Mohammed VI, to Lala Sulma, a computer scientist?
No idea.
Morocco. Judith, please. The ancient world. In ancient Greek cities, a public open space at the centre of the city, used as a market and meeting place, was known as what?
An agora.
Yes, or agora. Jennifer, please. Founded in 1791, which is Britain's oldest national Sunday newspaper?
Times.
The Observer. Deborah, what specifically is kept in an airtight container called a humidor?
Flour.
Cigars. John, please. A display of items called angels from Tudor times opened recently at the Museum of London. They were so named because of their image of the Archangel Michael defeating the devil. What are these angels?
I have no idea.
A collection of coins. Jan, please, British politics. Which political party has a blazing torch as its symbol?
The Labour Party.
Conservative Party. Jan, which is the most junior commissioned rank in the Royal Air Force?
Pilot officer.
It is. Kevin, in which European capital city are the Liechtenstein Palace, the island of Camper and the historic Charles Bridge, all of which were affected by the floods in August?
Prague.
Myra, please. Which classic science fiction character returned in the first exclusive online drama commissioned by the BBC for the internet with Sylvester McCoy voicing the hero?
I have no idea.
The Doctor, Doctor Who. And Norman, please. Meaning someone not to be trusted, what's the English translation of the Latin phrase anguis in herba?
No idea.
Snake in the grass. George, please. Thailand is ruled by a king. Japan is ruled by an emperor. What title is used by the reigning monarch of Brunei?
Sultan.
Michael, please. The Anschluss of 1938 refers to the annexation by Germany of which country?
38. Austria.
And Jenny, please. Newspapers. First published in New York in 1889 by Dow Jones and Company. What is the American equivalent of Britain's Financial Times? The Wall Street Journal. Keith, your second question. Children's rhymes. According to the rhyme, which day of the week's child is full of grace?
Wednesday.
Tuesdays. Lee, please. Which Barry is the son of the film director Leslie and the father of the film critic Emma?
Sorry.
Barry Norman. John, please. Fruits. Pomplamoose in French. Pompelmo in Italian. What's it called in English?
Grapefruit.
And Judith, please. Computing. What name is given to a computer program which allows calculations to be carried out on several columns and rows of numbers?
Sorry, I don't know that.
Spreadsheet. Jennifer? Its greatest length lying northeast to southwest is from Tor Head to Mizen Head. Which part of the geographical British Isles? Ireland, the island of Ireland. Deborah, the leading fashion designer for the Gucci group, was born in the east end of London, the son of a taxi driver, and was once dubbed enfant terrible by the press. What's his name?
Christopher.
Alexander McQueen. John, please. In dual polls of film critics and film directors carried out by the British Film Institute recently, which Orson Welles film of 1941 came top of both lists?
Citizen Kane.
Jan, please. Sir Anthony Grabham is the president of the BMA. What does BMA stand for?
British Medical Association.
Jan, please. Mythology. Which mythological creature is depicted with a human head, the body of a lion and the wings of a bird?
Griffin.
The Sphinx. And Kevin, please. Sport and cycling. Four cyclists share the distinction of having won the Tour de France five times. One of those four cyclists, please.
I'm sorry, I don't know that.
Miguel Indurain, Bernard Hinault, Eddie Merckx and Jacques Anquetil. And Myra, please. The head of the Crown Prosecution Service is also the DPP. What do those letters DPP stand for?
Director of Public Prosecution.
And Norman, please. State benefits. What's the connection between the weekly state benefit payments of £75.50 and £120.70?
Old age pensions.
Yes, single persons and a married couple. George, which wolf-like wild dog native to North and Central America is featured in the Roadrunner cartoons?
Rin-tin-tin.
Coyote. Michael, please. Its frequencies are 693 and 909 medium wave. It broadcasts news and sport 24 hours a day. Which BBC network radio service is it?
It's Radio 5 Live.
And proverbs, Jenny. According to a famous French proverb, if you're born to be hanged, then you will never what?
Die.
Drown. It's 3 down, 12 to go, and those three must now leave us. And Laura, please.
And those eliminated are Jennifer Cox, Deborah Ashmore and Jenny Vere. And of the remaining 12 contestants, only one still has his three lives intact.
We start round two with Keith at number one, the first correct answer, we can start nominating. And we start with literature. Keith? Which best-selling book by Nick Hornby, made into a film, charts his personal relationship with Arsenal Football Club?
Fever.
More than that, quickly.
Fever Pitch.
Yes, OK. If you're halfway there, I'll give you a chance. And onwards, please.
Number nine, please.
Jan, please. Science and technology. What is an odometer designed to measure? Odometer.
Speed.
No, distance. Again, please, Keith.
Seven, please.
The former president, Joaquin Balaguer, who died earlier this year, aged 95, ruled which Caribbean country, the eastern part of the island of Hispaniola, for most of the past 40 years? The Dominican Republic. Again, Keith?
14, please.
The Old Fire Station Theatre, the Pegasus Theatre and the Sheldonian Theatre, famous venues in which English city?
Bristol.
Oxford. Again, please.
12, please.
In 1965, with Virgil Grissom, he made the first manned flight in the Gemini programme. In 1981, he commanded the first space shuttle mission. Which astronaut?
John Glenn.
John Young. Again, please, Keith.
11, please.
Severiano Ballesteros won the first of his three Open titles. Martina Navratilova won the first two of her nine Wimbledon singles titles. And Ray Reardon won the last of his six World Snooker Championships. All in which decade?
70s.
And the number, please, Myra?
Four, please.
In which city is the Yorkshire Post newspaper based?
Bradford.
Leeds. Again, please, Myra?
Two.
Lee, Professor Philip King is the president of which arts establishment at Burlington House on Piccadilly in London?
Royal Academy.
Yes, indeed, Royal Academy of Arts. And onwards, Lee?
Number eight, please.
Which distillery in County Antrim received its licence in 1608, making it the oldest licensed whisky distillery in the world?
I don't know.
It's a famous name, Bushmills. Again, please, Lee?
14.
During World War II, the Queen Victoria Hospital in East Grinstead became famous for what type of medical treatment?
Treatment of war, shell-shocked people.
No, plastic surgery, mainly for airmen with burns. Again, please.
Number seven.
Prior to the entry of the United Kingdom, Ireland and Denmark in 1973, how many members of what is now the European Union were there?
Nine.
Six, the original six. Again, please.
Number 10.
And the name, please, of two of those six founding members of what is now the European Union?
France and Luxembourg.
Yes, You could have had Belgium, West Germany, Italy and the Netherlands. And a number, please, Janet.
Number one.
The international manufacturing company Chorus Group was created in 1999 when which former nationalised industry in Britain merged with a Dutch company, Hoekhoffens?
British Steel.
A number, please, Keith.
11, please.
Myra, European landmarks. Where in Paris is the tomb of the unknown warrior?
Les Invalides.
No, the Arc de Triomphe. Again, please.
14, please.
Gemstones. What term is used to describe a stone that is cut and polished but is domed and without facets?
No idea.
Cabochon. Again, please.
13, please.
The First World War, George. The 1st of July 1916, the start of the infantry assault at which major battle?
Battle of the Somme.
And a number, please, George.
10.
Which mode of transport has a ripcord, a vent, a basket and a burner?
Hot air balloon.
And number, please, Kevin.
Number 3.
John. Of which mammal are there types called ghost-faced, leaf-nosed, funnel-eared and sucker-footed? They're all types of bats. Again, please,
Number
Janet.
Two.
Famous sayings attributed to Benjamin Disraeli. Never complain and what? Never explain. Again, please.
Number 12.
Norman, please. Which body of the United Nations, with headquarters in Nairobi, promotes, quote, the achievement of adequate shelter for all?
UNESCO?
No, it's called Habitat. It's the United Nations Human Settlements Programme. Again, please.
13.
George, Canada's oldest city, founded in 1608, stands at the point where the St. Charles River meets the St. Lawrence and was the scene of Wolfe's famous victory over the French in 1759. Which city?
Quebec.
And a number, please.
I can't say. 11.
And Myra, the ancient world. Medea, who killed her own children because of her husband's unfaithfulness, is the subject of a play by Euripides. Who was her husband?
Jason.
Yes, he of the Argonauts and the Golden Fleece. A number, Myra?
One, please.
Which Russian poet and writer was fatally wounded in a duel with his wife's admirer in 1837?
Turgenev.
Alexander Pushkin. Again, please, Myra.
3, please.
ZR is the symbol for which chemical element?
Zirconium.
A number, please, John.
9.
The Russian Mikhail Fokine, the American Martha Graham, and the Briton John Cranko. Famous names in which of the arts?
Ballet.
Yes, dance. All forms of dance, I suppose. And onwards, Jan.
Number 4, please.
Judith, which sea lies off the east coast of Australia, north of the Tasman Sea and south of the Solomon Sea?
Pacific.
The Coral Sea. Again, Jan.
Number 13.
The villages of Lindsay and Kersey, which gave their names to specific wool fabrics, are in which English county?
Lancashire.
Suffolk. Again, please.
Number 11.
Myra, please. Christian Dior pioneered the new look. India became independent. Rab Butler's Education Act raised the school leaving age to 15. All in which decade of the 20th century?
The 40s.
And number, please, Myra?
8, please.
In 17th and 18th century London, what sort of well-known establishments specifically were Buttons, Slaughter's, Don Soltero's and Will's?
Banks.
No, they were very famous coffee houses. A number, Myra?
9, please.
And Jan, please. Science. Traditionally, gunpowder is principally a mixture of potassium nitrate, charcoal, and which yellow non-metallic element?
Sulphur.
A number, please, Jan?
Number 1.
Music, Keith. The Italian musical term parlando indicates that the piece is to be sung in what manner?
As a spoken voice.
Yes, like Rick Harrison. Yeah. My Fair Lady.
3, please.
And John, please. A treaty of mutual defence called the Anzus Treaty was signed in 1951 between which three countries?
Britain, France and Germany.
Australia, New Zealand and the United States. Again?
13, please.
And George, please. Which English poet wrote Ode on a Distant Prospect of Eton College and Ode on the Death of a Favourite Cat Drowned in a Tub of Goldfishes?
Edward Lear.
Thomas Gray. Again, please.
11, please.
And Myra, please. In 1271, as a 17-year-old, he set out with his father Niccolo and his uncle Maffeo. He did not return home until he was 42. Which famous Venetian adventurer?
Marco Polo.
A number, please, Myra.